Scenic Blast Stakes Day. 1,000 metres, they're off and they're racing. Rock This Town Avoidance and Universal Flair all out of the gates very well. Pushing up Land of Villains, Lexington City's going to hold a spot just behind those and will be ideally placed soon after the start. Potshot is on the rail. Ruler Rocket stranded a little bit wide. Avoidance went back soon after the start, followed by Honeydew, Madam Kisses, and last of all, My Dilemma. As they race along past the 550 and the leader, Rock This Town, out three quarters, Universal Flair, third on the rail, Land of Valens. Lexington City's up, ideally placed, travelling fourth as they set sail for the judge. Behind it, Avoidance, Potshot angling off the fence. Ruler Rocket going up near the middle is next of all. Madam Kisses back near the rail at the 220, and Rock This Town's in front. Rock This Town kicks. He's too clear, Lexington City. Rock This Town still by two. Lexington City trying to pick him up. Rock This Town shortening stride, the post coming. Lexington City dived at Rock This Town. Rock This Town, I thought, from Lexington City. Potshot flew late. Behind the My Dilemma, Ruler Rocket, Madam Kisses ahead of Honeydew Avoidance. Followed further back, Land of Valens and Universal Flair. Waiting for the numbers here after the running of the night. The last of the day, Rock This Town, Braden Garth. Showing dazzling speed and has held on, had enough in hand. To beat three, Lexington City, nine, Potshot, and four, Madam Kisses, officially fourth. The interim numbers to the last of 5, 3, 9, and 4. Rock This Town. Very, very underrated short course sprinter for Peter Farrell, written by Braden Garth, the son of Awesome Rock, and posts his fourth win from 11, all four at the short course, the 1,000 metres. Rock This Town. For B, P. Williams, Mrs. K, and P.B. Farrell, and has scored by a short head in 58-82, home in 34-1-1. A short head, a short neck of the margins. Lexington City is second. Holly Watson for Simon Miller. A City Place gelding out of Kentucky Lass. Third, Potshot. Attacked the line hard late first up. Clint Johnston Porter for Dion Luciani by demerit from Onzi Move. So 5, 3, 9, and 4 to the final race for the day. And a nice metro win here at Ascot for Rock This Town, part owner and trainer Peter Farrell. Lockie Taylor's down in the yard and about to catch up with those connections as Shorty Farrell makes his way to the winner's enclosure. It's great to see at Ascot.
He certainly does. It's a great sight to see Shorty Farrell in the winner's circle in town at Ascot. As Darren just said, Shorty, congratulations. What were you thinking in the concluding stages? Were you confident that he had held on?
Not really, no. I was doing a bit of cheering, that's for sure.
It was an interesting run race in the sense that there was an abundance of speed on paper. What were your discussions like with Braden pre-race?
I just said once I put the blinkers on him, even last start, he showed a lot more speed. I know he's got natural speed, but like when I put the blinkers on, he was showing a lot more speed. So I thought he would find the front. Whether he got pressure, that was going to be the biggest thing.
In the end, he didn't actually receive as much pressure as many people thought. Were you rising in confidence as the race eventuated?
Once he got an easy sectionals in front and he kicked off the corner, I was pretty confident, but there was one coming late. So,
is it fair to say he's perhaps a touch underrated? He's now a winner of 5 from 11. He continues to go through his grades really nicely.
Yeah, he's a very hard horse to deal with. I'll get grey hairs before he does, that's for sure.
Great result. Great to see you in the winner's circle.
All right, thank you.
There's Peter Shorty Farrell after the win of Rock This Town, leading all the way. A really well-rated ride from Braden Garth, who has celebrated a really nice week in the saddle. And as of Wednesday afternoon at Ascot, he will no longer be riding with a 3-kilo claim, Michael.
Yes, he's made a real splash in the metro area of late, so he's down to 2 kilos as of this week. A nice time to be going quite well at the moment with Luke Campbell's suspended at the moment, so he'll be back in a couple of weeks, no doubt, the leading apprentice at the moment. But we've had some other jockeys come out of their time recently, and he gets a great opportunity now to be one of the leading apprentices, especially in the metropolitan area. He has been going to meetings like Esperance and some others on Saturdays recently, but today certainly made the right call staying here in Perth and was able to get a win on the board. We'll grab a word with Braden. He's just going to the wrong scales at the moment, but Chief Steward Brad Lewis is steering him in the right direction. Then it's no rest for the wicked. Braden's off to Mount Barker tomorrow. I think he's aboard Benji's in the sprint. Braden, there was a stack of speed on pressure, a stack of speed in this race. In the end, he actually got it pretty cheap.
Yeah, it was actually pretty scary looking at it on paper, but I know this bloke's absolutely rapid. I was pretty confident we'd be able to out-sprint him all early. Nice little breather in between, but geez, he was tough late to keep going the way he did and quicken at the top of the straight, very impressive.
Our other horse was coming pretty hard over the final stages. Could you hear it coming?
It was. I actually thought for a brief moment it was going to roll me, but yeah, credit to my bloke, really tough. As soon as he came, he let another gear down and found the line really strong.
2 kilo claimer, and as of next week, how do you feel about that?
Yeah, obviously having the 3 kilos is pretty handy, but it's got to go at some point, so it's good.
Yep, you're riding really well. Well done.
Thank you very much.
There's Braden Garth rounding out the day as a winner, combining with Peter Farrell and Rock This Town to take out the Peter's Investments Handicap. That's all we have time for tonight. Michael and I will be back at Mount Barker tomorrow for the Mount Barker Sprint. Got nothing in my brain. Shake it out, shake it out.